made you some content. Daddy made you your favorite open wide. Here comes the content. It's a beautiful day to stay inside.
Greetings, mood killers. I'm Bolognese Francine Marconi, along with Eddie Barella. We are enjoyers of doom and dysfunction, and today we have lots of gooey content to get to you today. That's our only goal, really, is to shoot you with gooey content. That doesn't sound right. Let me take that back.
Doesn't sound right.
We're not going to do that at all. I mean, we are going to give you content, but we're not, it's not going to come towards you in any fashion, and it's not really that
gooey.
It's not
firing. It's not shooting. Yeah.
It's not sticky. It's not gooey. It's just content, okay? I'm sorry.
Being slimed in any way.
Yeah. Although I remember that.
It's fine.
Coming up, however, have you ever been flirting with someone, Eddie, only to find out that they return to their ex the next day? I have a few things that you might be able to relate to in my Marconi logs coming up.
Okay. All right. And Marconi, what is chroming? Chroming. Well, I'll tell you. It's a new social media trend, and it's deadly.
Oh.
More coming up in our tech news segment, the Tech Tickle.
I like that you have to describe it as, like, it's the tech news segment.
Right, because, I mean, social media falls into the tech file, I'm going to say.
Yes. No, yeah.
Yes, because social media is very technologically advanced.
Well, it is, absolutely. Except for Twitter.
Tech.
Plus, Eddie, are you tired of wasting money on streaming services you don't watch? I mean, come on. I have a few things, a few tips and tricks that might help you with that. Plus, a few ways you can get your money back on Amazon purchases without having to send anything in the mail. I'll have that in Save On coming up. Save On!
Oh, wow.
Yes, all of
the
this.
Tech Tickle and Save On, the Marconi blog. We have so much going on today.
We're here to give it back to you. We're giving back, really. It's on the only show where hope goes to die. Eddie, make sure and click on our hot clips on our socialized medias. We are on Instagram and Facebook at Mood Killers. Once in a while, you'll see a hot clip with us talking, you know, clips from the show or something, and maybe you've heard it, maybe you haven't. It's supposed to lure people in, you know? Like, wow.
They're all hot. We can say that much. They're spicy.
<right. laughs> I think somebody suggested we call them sweaty clips, but that doesn't sound like something.
Greasy? How about greasy?
No, nobody wants any of that. So,
greasy clips.
Yeah, so look out for our hot clips, and, you know, if you are listening now and you see one of our hot clips, you know, click like and then leave a tooth emoji in the comments. That way we'll know you're paying attention. We really do appreciate it.
So then share the clip with your podiatrist. Yeah, go ahead,
that's right. Right.
Yeah.
Eddie, this is a segment that's near and dear to my heart. I write things, and some of these are entries that I did, I think, last summer. So some of them you may have heard before, but I thought I'd give them back to you again because, you know, not everybody pays attention the first time.
So, yeah, I mean, I have a short-term memory, so thank you for reminding me. Appreciate it.
And, you know, when you listen to radio, they play the same songs over and over, so why can't I do a couple of pieces of content that I've done before? Come on!
I know. Let's just rotate the same 20 things over and over again because the radio station plays the same 20 songs.
That's right.
It's fair.
It's called recycling. We're giving back to the earth.
Right. Green.
You know, okay, here's something from my Marconi log, an entry. When I experience symptoms of dehydration, I quickly eat a tub of cream cheese so I can rule out that I'm not just thirsty for cream cheese. You gotta make sure, because what if it was that? You don't know. Eddie, I don't know what the five love languages are, but one of them better have peanut butter inside, you know? If all the pizza cutters are dirty, then one whole pizza counts as a serving, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
That also goes for, like, if your office donuts, they don't count on your calorie. That's off the radar. Like that was.
Yeah. I like the people who cut it in half too. Then they leave half of a donut. It's like, oh, give me a break. Yeah. Screw you. I know you're coming back for that other half when no one's looking.
Yeah. Right. Jerk. Yeah. You know, because I would work late night at the radio stations sometimes, and there would always be residual food left over from the day, like if they had a pizza party during the day. And it wasn't that bad because, you know, although the pizza had been sitting in a box, it was still good. And the thing was, is it was left behind, so nobody else was going to eat it. It was going to go bad if I didn't take it. So who am I to say, you know, let food be wasted on my watch?
You can't. Yeah.
And I like that because it was like an unplanned dinner. Like, oh, I was going to make dinner. I was going to do something for dinner. And it's like, oh, no, you have pizza at work. So that was.
That really is the best part of working at a radio station is having the food dropped off all the time because every day it was. I probably, you know, when I used to have this happen at work all the time, it doesn't happen so much these days, but, you know. It seems like there would be fast food places bringing in burgers or whatever, like literally every day. And I gained so much weight over the span of like 3 or 4 months. I just had to stop it. And it's tempting because you bring in your salad and then somebody brings in all these beautiful cheeseburgers. It's really, it's so hard.
You get a tray of hot cheeseburgers and you're sitting there going, I'm really going to eat a salad? Who am I? What am I doing?
Right.
What's going on? Free cheeseburgers or free pizza. But the thing is, here's the caveat. Radio sometimes will want to pay their employees so low, but they'll have these little parties. Look how great our work is. Like, no, just pay me so I can afford to do these parties on my own instead of being, instead of it being like, oh, thank God I don't have to spend money on dinner tonight. You know what I mean?
Right.
Eddie, I'm sharing with you some of my most intimate thoughts. These are my Marconi logs and some of these entries. Go way back. You may have heard some of them before, but I thought, you know, people recycle things all the time, so why not here on the show? I don't know who needs to hear this, but your culinary experience improves once you realize your smoke alarm isn't a cook timer. Or, you know, like the toaster. Like, you know, when you move into that apartment, it's brand new, and for whatever reason, a little burnt toast sets off a fire alarm. It's so annoying.
Yeah. I mean, every time you move into a new place, you have to test the limits of the smoke detector. And you do that by, you know, throwing hot grease on a pan, then you turn it on high heat and just walk away for an extended period of time. That's what I usually do to christen a new apartment. So
you burn down the new apartment and then you're like, okay, I guess I was wrong. Not to brag, but once I was flirting with this girl. And a day later, she got back together with her ex.
You traumatized her into going back home.
Well, maybe she just realized, like, you know, her relationship wasn't that bad when she started talking to me. I don't mind being that for someone to help them realize, but it's still personally painful. You know, just especially when you think, oh, this could be, I don't know, maybe she's cute. I don't know.
Right.
Eddie, when you date someone with the same sense of humor as yours, you have to deal with the consequences. Like, I once asked my girlfriend to put on an outfit that I hadn't seen before, and she walked out with my gym clothes on. At least, though, she did with a huge piece of cake. You know,
so I have to say, though, I don't know if you necessarily want to date somebody with the same sense of humor. I've done it before. Then after a while, you start to annoy yourself and it's not even you talking.
You mean they annoy you because they're so much like you? You know, it is a certain point where it almost becomes a competition. And it's kind of
weird. And then everyone's unhappy at some point. Then you both start. It creates a lot of conflict. I think you need. I think one person in the relationship has to think the other one is hilarious, and it stops there.
Yeah. The problem with me is they start out thinking, quote unquote, that I'm hilarious, and then that ends real quick. I have to ugly cry for the facial recognition on my phone to work. What's it? You know, when you're doing that, when you're sitting in your car eating gas station hot dogs and you can't get your phone open and the greases are all over your finger from the oily hot dogs. And then you're like, okay, the facial recognition, turn on. I want to scroll some TikToks at least, you know. And then you realize the only way it's going to do it is if you start bawling your eyes out. And then it finally works.
This is every Tuesday afternoon for me, yeah.
Yes. Eddie, if I say goodnight and an hour later you see me online, it's not that I lied to you. It's that I failed. You got to be very careful, you know, because, you know, sometimes people think, oh, yeah, sure, he's going to bed. And then you see me goofing around or liking somebody's, you know, posts or something like that. You're like, hey, what's going on? So it's just because I can't get to sleep. Here's another one, Eddie, from my Marconi logs. I'm sorry for the things I said when you opened a new carton of oat milk when there was one already open. Why do I have like 1,000 cartons of oat milk.
Milk.
I can't say.
I always do that too, because I always like to have an extra carton of oat milk in case I run out of one. But then inevitably, you know, the way that they package these things, you can't tell it if the little seal is snapped on the top when you turn the little spout or not. So like I'll sometimes reach for the one that is not opened yet, even though I have to finish another one.
That have the hard ring in it that you have to pull out with a finger. And you're like, and then it's like a carton. And then the thing I don't like, though, is because I do oat milk in my smoothies and oat milk in my coffee, I've got to have, you know, and I order groceries just for every 2 weeks. I've got to have like 5 cartons of oat milk in my refrigerator at all times. So you saying 2, I'm like, come on, what are you doing? How do you even survive?
Taking a look at tech news with the Tech Tickle. Marconi, tech happens all around us, and when it does, the Tech Tickle on Mood Killers is here to talk about everything happening in the world of tech. Now, self-driving cars. I know that you are a big fan of these. Self-driving cars, Tesla.
No, I'm not.
But apparently,
Tesla can go to hell. You know what I think about Tesla? Yeah. I think the self-driving car is a crock of crap, because I've seen people.
Well, according to this, it may be, but go ahead.
Every time I see one, it looks like somebody doing an ad, like on social media. Like, hey, look, I'm in a car and there's no driver. Hey, here's a viral, quote unquote, viral video of an old guy getting into a driverless car and losing his mind. Like, oh my gosh, I can't believe it. It's like, come on, stop it.
Yeah. Well, you know, the self-driving cars, I always thought that the whole idea behind it is that if everybody's in a self-driving car, then traffic is going to be a lot better. But it turns out that self-driving cars may be making traffic worse.
Good.
Because they are unable to understand human behavior and could potentially be hazardous due to their inability to comprehend what other drivers are going to do. You know, it's not a perfect technology. There's still not that human aspect to it. So
give it a couple hours. An AI will figure it out, right? What they just need to do is hook up ChatGPT to the car, and then it'll figure it out in like a couple of days.
Or just take the wheel yourself. You know? You could do that too, I guess. But honestly, people are terrible drivers. So the AI is bad, and also the people are bad. I just like to stay off the road as much as possible.
Take
the
train, you know, try the train. People are, you know, and I know the train has its down points too, but there's nothing like being able to step on a moving thing and not having to park or not having to worry about a ticket or not, you know, paying for gas, you know, all that stuff.
Right.
And you're just there at your place, and it's fantastic.
Yeah. 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 And this is something that we've been asking for a long time, having our iPhone remember curse words. This doesn't happen currently, but there's a new update to Apple's iOS 17, and the keyboard will finally be able to learn curse words. So no longer will I be telling people about ducks.
Good, because I just noticed that there's a thing called beta updates on my phone. Mine says automatically turned off. I'm going to turn off to iPhone iOS 17 developer beta. I'm going to turn it on, right?
Right.
That's what I want.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. So it's about damn time, because isn't it annoying when you're trying to curse in a text message and you have to rewrite it 50 times? It's like,
I don't
grow
understand.
Up, Tim Cook. People curse.
Do you think people are too freaked out if their AI on their phones and stuff knows their settings? Like if I go to you know, Siri or something like that and say, hey, play my playlist or whatever. It's kind of weird that you have to say that every time, you know, just previous playlist or play it again, Sam, you know, some kind of a thing that could just, you know, cue that I want to listen to my Taylor Swift, The Ones playlist on Spotify. Is that so wrong?
Are you listening, Tim Apple?
He doesn't want to make, and that's the other thing that drives me nuts about tech. They're all in competition with each other, but I'm not in competition with any of them. Let me have Google and Apple and Spotify all work on one phone. I don't want to buy a dumb Google phone so I can have all the Google features. And I don't want Apple to say no to Spotify or other things just because they have a vested interest in you listening to iTunes all the time. Knock it off.
You hear that? He wants Zuckerberg, Bezos, and Tim Cook in bed together.
That's right.
Marconi, the tech tickle continues.
Right here. Wait, say it again. The tech tickle continues.
Continues. Yes. That's right. Here on Mood Killers, we're taking a look at tech news. Now, let me ask you this question. I know you like to watch a lot of streaming services. Mm. Yeah, we talk about them a lot here on Mood Killers. Do you have the subtitles on or off?
Always on, because you never know when you're going to eat. Never know when you're going to be eating chips. Because, I mean, if you eat cereal and you can't hear it, and usually cereal is like I ate dinner, but I'm also still hungry. But I don't want a full meal, but a bowl of cereal is good, you know, as a late night snack. And then you can't hear the TV.
I thought this is interesting. You are actually in the majority of Americans. According to the vice president of Roku, Tom Roku, 58% of subscribers use subtitles. 58%. Now, 38% of them have them because of a diagnosed hearing impairment. Oh. 32% do it out of habit. And, you know, maybe they have situations where kids are over or someone's trying to sleep next to them or... I put on subtitles, especially when I'm watching Christopher Nolan movies, because guy does not know how to mix sound in any of his movies.
That's true.
I don't know if you've seen, like, Tenet. Tried to watch Tenet. I missed half the dialogue because there are, like, explosions that are 10 times louder than the dialogue.
What is that about these movies?
I don't know.
And I thought, you can't hear what they're saying. Obama made a big law that streaming services couldn't blast commercials louder. If you have commercials to watch, then the show.
Did Obama do that?
Yeah, there was some kind of a thing that streaming services signed into a law that you couldn't have blasting commercials. And it still happens all the time. Like, you'll be listening.
Then I think what happened is the other party took control of the government and then they took away that restriction. Mm. And what they're trying to do now is make it seem like volume is all over the place, you know, and everything is going to hell with the volume on your TV set. And then once that party's back into power, they're going to regulate the volume again. You see what I'm saying?
I see. Right, right.
And then they're going to be the saviors of your TV volume.
Finally.
It's all political. Yes. It's all political with the TV volume.
I'm tired of everyone It's a political stunt. Between Apple, Google, Spotify not getting along, and, you know, all these tech companies. And then the government can't get along. Nobody's doing anything. Everybody's fighting, and nobody's getting any solutions for the people. I'm here
and nobody's
to get solutions for the people.
Can you make my damn TV one consistent volume? And I need to hear what the hell people are saying.
Yeah, and the other thing is Alexa has the same issue. Like, you know, one time you'll ask for the weather or something like that, and it'll be at, like, volume 7. And then why can't you just have a default volume for everything and have everything raised or lowered according to that level? Like, you know, if something's low, then have it automatically raise it up.
Normalize it.
Yes.
It's a thing. It's called normalization. We do it on the radio. We do it with our podcast.
Right.
All the volume is one level. We figured it out and we're a couple of morons. Come on. You can't figure it out. Christopher Nolan and Tim Apple, get together.
Come on.
Do something. Okay. So what is chroming? Chroming? This is social media trend.
Uh-huh.
And parents need to know about this.
Okay. I'm going to say chroming, just as a guess, has something to do with Google Chrome and having way too many tabs open. Is that right? If you have, close?
If you have too many tabs open in your Chrome, your kids may pass out. That's right.
Well, because you're just like, I can't get the internet to work. I'm dying. Oh, you have 50 tabs open, son.
Well, chroming is something that, as a social media thing, this is really dumb, but it's coming from sniffing off Chrome-based paint.
What?
So I guess you're just,
saying, you're trying not to say it's a TikTok trend. It's a TikTok trend?
Well, apparently.
Oh, okay.
I'm not trying to, so I was like, TikTok.
Got to be a TikTok trend. So
this is a trend on TikTok. Yeah.
So I'm busy on Taylor Swift talk. You're going through sniff talk.
And the way that this article is talking about it, sniffing off Chrome based, isn't that just called huffing?
I don't know.
Right? So these
I never
kids
did
are
that
huffing.
Either. Nobody would believe that, but I never did any of that kind of stuff either. It's weird to think about the dumb things people do because they see it on the, social media, but
we got
Tide Pods. Remember all that? Fidget spinners were a thing for a while. All the dumb challenges that ice water challenge. Like, I challenge so-and-so, and it didn't solve anything, but they did it in the name of something. But I don't understand how that helped anything. But,
It didn't, yeah. And now people are huffing paints and taking videos. Don't do it because it says here that you will die. So
okay.
That.
Eddie, there's a lot of things going on with streaming services. I'm going to tell you how you can save some money. And I
Thank
know
you.
Some of this stuff is common sense, but not everybody thinks about this. Disney Plus, Netflix, Max, they have all these streaming services now, and some of them are combining. But when you really think about it, there are only a handful of shows that I'm into watching, like on Netflix. I watch Gilmore Girls all the time, especially now. That the content, I don't know what it is about that right now. And maybe they're holding back because of the writer's strike and stuff like that. They're saving just in case, things continue or, whatever. But it feels like the Netflix has a lot of bad content right now. And the only reason I hang on to it is because I don't own a digital copy of Gilmore Girls or Seinfeld, which I like to watch regularly on there. And so I looked at it.
Now, does Gilmore Girls have nudity? I'm looking it up right now.
Sir, it's a family show. How dare you?
Yes?
No.
Oh, okay.
And brilliant writing, by the way. It's a great show if you haven't checked it out. I know it sounds like something. I mean, for years I didn't get it. And then it got on Netflix and I started watching it. And I'm like, wait, I remember people telling me how good this was. And I laughed at it. And then I watched it. And I was like, oh. Well, they were right.
Now, why do you think that show gets such a bad rap? Do you think it's the name of the show?
I don't think it gets a bad rap
or
at all.
Or the network that it was on when it first started?
I just think toxic men are, they laugh at things like that. So, but people like it.
Is it? I don't even know what the show's about, to be honest.
It's really funny. I came here to help you save money on streaming services.
Now I'm subscribing to Netflix so I can watch Gilmore Girls, excuse me.
But you can buy Seinfeld digitally for $100, Gilmore Girls for $80. And so you can
buy. Now, does that go straight to Jerry himself, those proceeds, or do they split it equally amongst the cast?
What do you
think? Didn't have that information in front of you?
No.
You have your contract. I want to know where my money's going.
And do you do this? Because this is what I'm here to suggest, is cancel these subscriptions when the, say like Hulu doesn't really have a lot of content on there that's, some stuff is okay, but especially during the summer, there's not a lot of stuff to really watch. And so cancel it for the summer. Take a couple of months off of paying whatever, $14.99 for no ads or whatever it is, the bundle. And Disney Plus is kind of weak right now, too. But what they say is wait till a series, find out the number of episodes and then find out when those episodes are published. Then you subscribe for that month, binge it, and then cancel it again. And so you're...
So you have to kind of do your homework. You should probably set up a spreadsheet of some sort. And then if you're going to... purchase Seinfeld digitally, you should research how much of that $100 is going to Jason Alexander personally before you make that purchase.
I don't care. He can have all of it. It's fine with me. but yeah, and the only thing, like Curb, because it's not complete yet, I don't see a place where you can buy the complete seasons. So it's like $25 per season. So it's actually
that's
more
expensive.
Add up
because there's a lot of seasons. Yeah. That's a lot of money.
I think I did see something, and it's all through iTunes. And so that I think is worth it, getting a digital copy of it and just, you know, taking a break from Netflix when it's kind of weak, you know, and then sign up when it has a bunch of shows again.
You know, this is so much work. I'm just going to go back to pirating. Screw it.
Eddie, if you want to save on Amazon products, it can require a bit of time. You know, like if you say you buy something and, you know, 9 months later, something happens to it or it's not functioning the same way. Do you just buy another one and throw it away? Or do you go to Amazon and say, hey, this is not working correctly?
Now, I mean, it depends on how much time has passed. If, say, a year plus has passed, then I, you know, unfortunately, I'll just eat it. But at the same time, I don't agree with that because we don't. The whole premise behind that is annoying to me, how we don't make products to last anymore
right.
in this country. Back in the 1950s, you know, when I was purchasing a lot of dishwashers and washing machines, those things lasted forever.
They're still working now. No,
yeah.
So, you know, here's what has happened with me. Amazon seems to want to avoid having you send things back. And a lot of times if you pressure them a little bit, just in a, what you got to do is get on a chat, not like a phone call, actually get on like somebody on chat. You can be shirtless if you want to. You can do whatever you want, but you know, you can do it on your phone or on online or whatever in your desktop. And
I figured if I'm shirtless and on video, they'll want to get me off the call really fast. They're just going to give me whatever I ask for. Like, get this shirtless man out of here.
I'm just talking a textual, not a video chat. But, you know, my experience has been, it does take a little doing. So if you have a little time, for instance, here are some examples of how I've gotten my money back. I bought these Puck lights because I really like Puck lights. But I didn't have enough of them, so I'll try another brand. Because
what are Puck lights?
Those USB rechargeable lights that you can put a magnet. They have a magnet on the back, and there's a piece of an adhesive metal, and you can stick it anywhere. Uh-huh. And then you've got lights that will automatically turn on when you walk by them in the room. So you've heard of Puck lights before, haven't you? Okay, well, you know, like you can. These USB lights that are rechargeable, you know, you can put them underneath your cabinets in your kitchen or whatever, and they turn on whenever they see motion or whatever. So
it's like a light show when you get up in the middle of the night to pee. Like,
that's right. Like, well, you've talked about amazing. This before, having, you don't, if you turn on the bright lights above, which I don't do,
it can cause cancer, they say.
No, it wakes you up. So the Puck lights, here's the situation. I said, hey, look, the lights, the glue came undone or the magnet fell off, something like that. And so they, instead of having me send them back, they said, you know, dispose of them or recycle them or whatever, and we'll give you a full refund. Got the full refund. Same thing happened with some cat food. I ordered, I placed
you
an order.
You said this doesn't taste right.
right. Yeah.
You should try that and see what happens.
It just doesn't taste right to me. I don't know what it is.
I tried almond milk and I tried oat milk. Neither gave the right flavor. I'm not sure what's going on.
So then I just said, you know, one of the things is missing because they left one out. And so they were going to give me partial credit. And I'm like, well, I can't buy this with partial credit because it only comes together. And so then they go, okay, we'll give you the full credit. So then I got free cat food, right? So that was enough, like a 3 months
worth
of cat.
You've been eating like a king.
That's right. And then those storage containers, after a year, they started crumbling. And I said, hey, you know, you wouldn't expect after a year this to just crackle and crumble under, you know, regular use. And they gave me full credit. So free storage containers. And then...
Beautiful.
Yesterday, I noticed that my toilet seat, my beautiful toilet seat. Now, when you get a new toilet seat, one of the greatest features is the slow close because it doesn't slam.
Yes. I hate the slam.
So just the other day, I noticed that my seat, after less than 9 months, the slow close stopped working. And now nine months, that seems like it would be outside of the window. And it was. But I went to Amazon and I said, listen, I don't know what's going on, but after 9 months with, you know, usually you don't think about a toilet seat until, like, you know, you move to a new place or something. And so I only had it 9 months. So it took some doing. They wanted me to send it to them. Can you imagine?
Yeah, they're like, send it back to us. We're going to hose it down and give it to somebody else who orders it.
Can you imagine having to?
What are they going
to
do with that?
Bring this thing to UPS? I'm like, and I go, listen.
Just put it, if you just put a postage stamp on it and put it by your mailbox, they'll take it.
Well, they're going to give me, you know, they give you the label or whatever, but I had to take it to UPS.
I was going to put like a 25-cent stamp on it.
Yeah, just put it on there. Or just put it in the free pile as you walk out of your apartment building. No, So eventually I said, look, this isn't even hygienically okay. I don't think I can send it through the mail. I mean, it's a toilet seat. It's clean, but still, it's a toilet seat that's been used.
Yeah.
And
like, we just got over a pandemic. Can you imagine trying to send a used toilet seat that at the height of the pandemic?
God,
these people are nuts.
And so finally, they refunded, gave me complete store credit. And another new toilet seat with a slow close lid is on its way. So miracles can happen. All I'm saying is just stay on them. And a lot of times it's easier to just do it in the text chat. And maybe it'll work out for you. I mean, you know, spend 3 or 4 hours on the phone to get a $38 refund. It's totally worth it.
It's totally worth it. Just ask to speak to the manager.
Mood Killers.